Hi, I'm John Isner, and you're Inside Tennis with The Cause.
Tennis fans, thanks for staying with us. Mal Washington, who founded the award-winning Mal Washington Youth Foundation, has been helping change lives through education and tennis. Catching up with Mal Washington, one of the most respected tennis contributors in our game. Mal, you were born here, New York. You know this place, but you spent most of the time in Michigan. What was it like with Team Washington growing up in Michigan?
Well, it was great. I mean, I kind of jokingly say that in our household, we went to school, we ate, we slept, we went to church, and we played tennis. I mean, those are really the only five things we did when I was a kid growing up, and none of them, we couldn't skip any of them. I mean, you had to eat, you had to sleep, you had to go to school, church, and tennis. And I think we did a lot of hours of those. That's just the way it was for us. I mean, we played tennis together. I grew up playing with my older sister, Makila, and a lot of people don't know this, but my older sister, of all the Washington, she was the first one to go out on the professional tour back in the 80s. And she had a little bit of success, and for a while she had the bragging rights because she was the only one to reach the top 100 in the world. And then once I reached that, I had all the bragging rights. And so it's funny because everyone in our family has something in tennis that they accomplished that someone else didn't accomplish.
Fast forward, you're at the Big Blue, University of Michigan. Happiest times there, in the classroom, on the tennis courts, socially.
My happiest, I'll be honest with you, my happiest times were not in the classroom, but I remember my freshman year. I had a good time my freshman year, no question. It was a completely different experience. I was away from home and I was in college and, you know, had the opportunity to play at the great University of Michigan. And I remember after that first semester, I had a nice talking to by my coach, and he says, I think we need to reprioritize a few things. And after that first semester, I settled in and got my priorities straight and had a lot of success my freshman year, had even more success my sophomore year. But having the opportunity to go to University of Michigan, improve my tennis, improve my education, and improve socially and emotionally and build my character on that team, specifically that team in that university, was tremendous. And it's really what propelled me to the professional tour.
All of a sudden, you're on grass in the semifinals. The opponent is a big tenor himself, Todd Martin. What was it like being in the semifinals playing another big tenor? I mean, that had to be amazing for the conference.
It was pretty cool that Todd went to Northwestern and we played in college.
Head to head.
And I specifically remember at Northwestern, Todd beat me at 7-6 in the third. And I'm still disappointed about that loss. But whenever we talk about our head-to-heads, I always bring up Wimbledon because I got him in the big one. But that day at Wimbledon in the semifinal, having two guys from Michigan, two Big Ten guys, battling it out for the final of Wimbledon, it was a great opportunity for one of us.
You're playing Krajicek in the finals.
And I got bettered that day by Richard Krajicek. And as great of a disappointment it was, it was also a special moment because, you know, that was the pinnacle of my career. It's what every tennis player tries to do, and I know most tennis players are never going to reach it, but being the competitor that I am, I always felt like there was something more I could have done, either in that match or that tournament or that summer, or certainly in my career. But you take what you're given and you try to, hopefully you can walk away from the game and you can say, I gave it all I had and I'm happy.
Your career reached a pinnacle of 11 on the ATP, a near top tenor, four championships that you collected yourself. All of a sudden you're battling bad knees. And what was that like? You could feel the career might be winding down because of this infirmity?
Honestly, it was disappointing. It was, in my career, I felt like I wanted to play, you know, a good 12, 13 years out there. I felt like that was a good number for me. And ironically, after the biggest summer of my career, the finals of Wimbledon in 96, followed up by the Olympic Games in Atlanta in 96, within 7 months, it was, believe it or not, it was the beginning of the end of my career. And my knee didn't allow me to go much further. And in 1999, I retired at the old age of 30 years old. I retired from the game that I loved. But I have nothing but good memories when I think about my time on the ATP Tour.
all of a sudden you're in the most rewarding part of your life. You launch the Mal Washington Youth Education Foundation. Share how meaningful that is for the kids and for you personally.
You know what? You oftentimes when you give up your time or your money or your energy toward a cause, you actually get a lot in return as well. And I get a good feeling knowing that what we're doing with my youth foundation in Jacksonville, Florida, and what we've been doing for literally 21 years now, is really giving a lot of young people hope. And I like to say we're serving hope and changing lives. And I genuinely believe that we have literally saved lives of youth because we're giving them after-school opportunities, help them realize that there is no limit to what they can achieve if they're willing to put in the time and if they're willing to stay on track. So we're helping them stay on track.
Mal Washington, you're a man of pleasure to be around. Thanks for your time and your friendship today. Thank you.
Kaz, thanks so much. I appreciate the opportunity. Have a great day.
I'm Mike.
I'm Bob.
You're Inside Tennis with the Kaz.